Hello everyone, my name is Auro and welcome to the Devlog number 2 of my second game that still doesn't have a name yet. Maybe soon. In the last Devlog, I got the basic game mechanic to a pretty nice state. In this Devlog, I will be defining the art style for the game and also building a simple turn-based system. Let's get started right away. As I now have the basic game mechanic in a nice playable state, I figured I would next spare a moment to think how I am going to handle the graphics. My idea initially was to use vector art for the graphics, so I could scale the game at will. I did some investigating and found out that Unity doesn't actually natively support vector art. They have a package for it, but it's just a preview package and isn't really meant to be used in actual products. Nevertheless, I wanted to try it out. I created a simple box in Inkscape and then saved it in .svg vector format and also exported a high-resolution .png version of it. I then put them side by side in Unity. As you can see, they look quite different from each other despite being the same box. I read that different vector art programs handle the files differently, so I don't know if this difference is because of Unity or Inkscape. Whichever it is, this kind of difference is not acceptable when you actually want to make a releasable game. But I still wanted to see if these two boxes had other differences. Vector art shines in being scalable, so I thought zooming in would be a good test. I don't know how well you can see it in the video, but the high-resolution PNG has a bit of blur on the edge, while the vector version is really crisp. In this case, I actually prefer the PNG version. The edges of the vector box could be made smoother with some anti-aliasing, but it doesn't matter as I cannot really see any benefit for me to use the vector file over a high-resolution PNG file. So with my graphics, I think I will aim for getting them done with vector art, but for Unity, I will just get a high-resolution PNG export. It took me some time to think through how I want to handle the room graphics in Unity. Would I have one sprite per room, or would I combine it from parts in Unity? I figured I want to have control of the different room elements in the game, so it's better for me to have them as separate sprites. At least the floor and the walls. Yeah, doesn't look very pretty currently, but hey, I am no artist. For the doors, I can hide the walls with a sprite mask, so I can have more freedom over door placement. I am not yet sure though how good that might look with my final graphics, but for now, I'll go with the assumption that I will handle the doors with a sprite mask, so I can create doors dynamically in the game. As for the floor, I want to keep the shape of the floor and the texture of the floor separate. This way, I can easily have many different kinds of rooms with many different kinds of floor textures. After some thinking and googling, I concluded that a shader would be the best way to achieve this. I had never touched shaders before, but with the help of a practice video, I was able to set up the universal render pipeline and create my own shader graph. The visual shader tool for Unity seems really handy. There is still a learning curve involved with it, but luckily my needs are not that complicated, at least for now. I now have a shader that I can use to apply any texture to the shape of the room and adjust the color. Later on, I noticed an issue with the shader where it was slightly increasing the size of the sprite. I am not exactly sure why it was doing that, but I had a hunch that it had something to do with the transparency, so I added one more line in the shader graph for the alpha to be defined by the original sprite, and luckily, that solved the issue. With the shader done, I realized I want to be able to separate the shape of the rooms and the details of the rooms. So for example, if I have a room type called bedroom, I want to be able to say that, okay, bedrooms can have two different shapes. I needed to do some code refactoring again, but it was relatively painless and now I have more control over how the rooms look without having to make a separate asset for each room type and shape combination. I made a few shapes just to play around with. I don't want to create too many in case I need to change something later on. Unfortunately, I don't think Swaggly is a piece I will keep in the final version of the game, and I was too lazy to place all the walls around him. So this is where our roads separate with Swaggly. He was a true hero, may he never be forgotten. Anyway, I also made it so that the doors are created in the code now. In the shape, I am storing details where the doors can be placed. For this, I need their coordinates and their rotation. My first idea was to store these in a dictionary, but in Unity, dictionaries don't show up in the editor, and I was too lazy to make a serialized dictionary that would show up in the editor. Then I had an epiphany that since the rotation is also a float along with the coordinates, why don't I store all of this in a vector tree? Vector tree, after all, is essentially just a container for three float values. So my x and the y are the coordinates, and the z that I don't need in 2D is the rotation variable. I don't know if this is a hacky way to do it, but hey, it works and it's efficient. I set the rooms to generate 1 to 3 doors randomly, and I also set it so that different room types have different coloring while being able to use different shapes that are assigned to them. I also decided to try out the 2D lighting system as I haven't tried it before. Turns out it's very easy to add to your game. Just add lights and make sure the material in your sprites is something that will react to those lights. But I decided that I won't add any lighting for now. I don't even know yet if I want to add lights to the game. The first big milestone with my game is to get the Steam page up for it. To help me reach this milestone, I decided to list everything that I need to have done to set it up. My goal is to get the Steam page up as soon as possible to start collecting those important wishlists. So I will start prioritizing these tasks over others. There are a few features to code that will keep me busy for a few days maybe, but quite soon I will need to start making decisions on how the game will play out, what the theme of the game will be, how I want the game to look like, and all that stuff. I am not really looking forward to it too much. I would rather keep adding new features to the game and working on the game mechanics, but it's important to get the Steam page up early, so I will just need to suck it up and prioritize working on these time-sensitive tasks. Luckily on that list were still a few fun tasks. I first started working on a simple turn-based system. While testing this, I noticed that I again have a problem with wrong locations being offered for room placement. I feel like this function keeps breaking up constantly. Luckily, I managed to fix it quite fast. This time, the problem was that I was rounding up numbers a bit too early in the calculations. It was pure coincidence that it had been working properly earlier. When I moved the location of the available blocks a bit, the issue immediately started showing itself. But once I got that bug fixed, I got back to working on the turn-based system. After ironing out a few small bugs, it seems to be working just fine. It basically just keeps track of whose turn it is and deals a new turn when a block is placed. Now, each player gets to place one block from the available options, after which they are reset and the next turn starts. Great, that will do for now. Originally my idea was to have two or more players and they would build their separate room networks relatively far from each other. But now that I am testing this, I am warming up to the idea that the players could start quite close to each other, so there would be this dynamic of trying to block each other or maybe have some special rooms that could disturb the other players. I added some quick colors to the walls to make it more clear which room belongs to which player. I just need to be careful not to overdo it with the colors, as my idea is to also have the different room types color-coded, so there is a risk of the game ending up looking like rainbow vomit. As long as it's pretty rainbow vomit, I don't mind, but ugly rainbow vomit is not good. As you might notice, if I zoom in, the floors on some of the blocks will occasionally clip through the walls. I tried changing a few things with how the sprites are imported and they made it less worse, but didn't remove it altogether. Although, I tried building a version of the game and I didn't see any issues in that version, So maybe the issue exists just within Unity. I am hoping it's this. If I can't solve it any other way, maybe at some point I will just shave one pixel from the edges of the floor, and then for doorways I'll have some separate doorway texture, which I might want to have anyway to make the seam between two rooms prettier. I think I now have to make it more clear what kind of a graphical style I want to aim for with the game, so I can start thinking about the different assets I will need. I think the game will need zooming functionality, so my plan is to use high resolution PNGs to make it smoother. I still decided to do a quick test with pixel graphics. When you are zoomed in, I think it looks pretty nice, but when I am zoomed out, the pixels start dancing, and that's not really what I want to go with. I put in some time to think through what kind of graphics I wanted in the game and what might look good. Thinking about what kind of themes I want to go for and considering different visual details. I also did some testing in the game by crudely copy-pasting some existing art directly into the editor and putting them side by side. All this helped me make some conclusions regarding the art. I didn't answer all the questions I had set for myself, but enough for now, enough to know what I want to look for. My idea is nice in the sense that it's not very demanding graphically. Getting the walls and floor tiles custom made would not be expensive, but I might want to decorate the rooms also, put a chair here, a table there, and so on. I think it would be a real hassle to, first of all, catalog everything I want and then coordinate that everything gets done properly. I don't think that would break my budget, but it would consume a lot of my time. So I would much rather get a license to use an existing set of assets where I could just pick and choose everything that I think looks nice. With this in mind, I was really lucky that I stumbled upon the Dungeons & Dragons cartography community. There are a lot of people making custom top-down view maps that they share with others for visualizing scenery and battles in role-playing sessions. I saw a lot of amazing art that would fit really well with my game idea. The only problem is that most of the art assets are available only for non-commercial use. Well, that's a bummer. But as they say, don't knock it until you tried. So I am now trying to contact the artists and see if there would be a way for me to use their assets in the game. While waiting for answers, I also did some thinking regarding the theme of the game and what are the story elements around it. I think I have a pretty good idea that I will probably go with, but I'll keep that a secret for a little while longer, at least until I have made the final decision on it. And that's where I will end this devlog. In the next one, I will keep working on making the game ready for a Steam page, and hopefully I will also be able to update the graphics soon. Alright, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.